Osgood-Schlatter disease. Osgood-Schlatter disease, also known as osteochondritis of the tibial tubercle, is a common cause of knee pain in growing children and young teenagers. It's characterized by inflammation in the area just below the knee where the tendon from the kneecap attaches to the shin bone, tibia. The tendon from the kneecap, patella, attaches down to the growth plate in the front of the leg bone, tibial tubercle. The thigh muscles, quadriceps, attach to the patella through the quadriceps tendon, and when they pull on the patella, this puts tension on the patellar tendon. The patellar tendon then pulls on the tibia in the area of the growth plate. Osgood-Schlatter disease is an overuse injury caused by repetitive strain and chronic avulsion of the secondary ossification center, apophysis, of the tibial tubercle. Chronic avulsion causes separation of the proximal patellar tendon insertion from the tibial tubercle, which results in elevation. As callus is laid down during healing, the tubercle may become markedly pronounced. Osgood-Schlatter occurs most frequently in participants of sports that involve running, cutting, and jumping such as football, basketball, etc. These activities place stress on the tibial tubercle through repetitive contraction of the quadriceps muscle. Symptoms. The most common presenting complaint is anterior knee pain that increases gradually over time. The pain is exacerbated by direct trauma, running, jumping, squatting, climbing stairs, or walking uphill, and is relieved by rest. A hard, painful bump can also appear on the front of the knee below the kneecap. This bump is new bone that grows in the place where the tendon pulls on the growth plate. Though the pain will go away, the bump may remain even after the child has grown up. In some cases, both knees have symptoms, although one knee may be worse than the other. Diagnosis. Your child's doctor will discuss your child's symptoms and general health. He will conduct a thorough examination of the knee to determine the cause of the pain. This will include applying pressure to the tibial tubercle, which should be tender or painful. In addition, the doctor may also ask your child to walk, run, jump, or kneel to see if the movements bring on painful symptoms. Imaging is not necessary to confirm the diagnosis in individuals with characteristic features, but may be necessary to exclude other conditions in patients with atypical complaints, such as pain at night, rest-related pain, acute onset of pain especially after trauma, etc. Prognosis. Children and adolescents and their parents require anticipatory guidance regarding the typical duration of the disease and its sequelae. Osgood-Schlatter disease typically is a benign and self-limited condition. Although a significant subset of patients may experience prolonged pain that may be associated with decreased sports-related function and quality of life, symptoms generally resolve once the growth plate is ossified. Complications. Complications and sequelae of Osgood-Schlatter disease may include persistent prominence of the tibial tubercle, persistent pain, and rarely, back knee or hyperextension of the knee, also known as genu recurvatum. It results from premature fusion of the anterior part of the upper tibial epiphyseal plate. Treatment. Analgesics or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, of limited duration as needed for pain. Wearing a protective pad over the tibial tubercle may prevent direct trauma to the tender tibial tubercle. The application of ice to the involved area after participating in sports activity may be helpful in reducing pain and swelling. Ice should be applied for 20 to 30 minutes at a time at least twice per day. Do not apply ice directly to the skin. Once pain is adequately controlled, Athletes with Osgood-Schlatter disease should participate in a rehabilitative program that includes stretching of the thigh muscles. Complete avoidance of sports activity is neither necessary nor recommended. Osgood-Schlatter is one condition in which playing with pain is permitted provided the pain is tolerated and resolves within 24 hours. Patients with persistent pain that alters their ability to participate in sports for more than 3 months may benefit from injection of hyperosmolar dextrose. 3 monthly injections of 12.5% dextrose with 1% lidocaine significantly improved intractable knee pain in adolescent athletes. Glucocorticoid injections generally are not recommended because of case reports of complications, primarily related to subcutaneous atrophy. Cast immobilization for 6 weeks indicated for severe symptoms not responding to previous conservative managements. Surgical management is reserved for patients who fail to respond to conservative measures. It is generally undertaken after closure of the proximal tibial growth plate. The surgery removes the bone fragments that are causing the irritation of the patellar tendon so that the knee is able to function fully without the pain. The surgery is not a cosmetic procedure. So if you had a knob on your knee before, it won't necessarily go away after surgery. After the surgery, patients can expect to be in a cast for 4 weeks and they will have to use crutches. After the cast is taken off, rehabilitation stretches and exercises will need to be done daily to help the knee regain its strength and range of motion. With the proper rehabilitation regimen and surgery, the patient can expect to be fully functioning and pain-free in a matter of months.